Hey everyone, Nick here, and today I'm going to show you just a little trick that I recently learned from a blog post made by Jon Peltier over at PeltierTech.com. This post was from 2013, and it was a post about how he overlaps multiple columns in a column chart. But there was one piece of this blog post that really stuck out to me, and I wanted to try it on my own chart because it was an issue that I was having, and it was how to keep the legend active in these non-default or these irregular chart types that involve a lot of tricking Excel on the back end. And so oftentimes when we make a chart like the one that you see right here, this is a vertical lollipop chart. These lollipops are actually just error bars, and this is just a 2D clustered column chart right here. So when I click around here, you can actually see the outline of each of those bars. I've just set them to the fill color to no fill so that they're invisible. But when you do that, you can also see up here in the legend, initiation, transition, and breakthrough, there are no color boxes next to each of those words. So as soon as I set the series of data, one of those series of bars to no fill, then also the color next to the legend item also disappears. So I wanted to know if there's a way to sort of keep that legend embedded and active in the chart. And using John's tip in his blog post, we can do that. So what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna bring back the colors on these bars so you can see them, and we'll recolor the same colors here. Now, when I do this, and as I change the colors, you're going to be able to see that those legend entries come back. Let's see if this is going to work. Solid fill. Oh, I don't want that. I want that to be orange. Perfect. Okay, so now you can see the 2D clustered column chart that we put in here, and then also at the top, the legend colors came back. So each of these items has that little colored square next to it. And by the way, this is just a chart showing visitor behavior observations in a museum across four different museum exhibits. And we use the visitor-based learning framework by Chantal Barrio to group those behaviors into three different behavioral categories. So initiation, transition, and breakthrough. And I'll post her the link to her paper down below as well. It's something we love to use in kind of the museum world when we're observing visitor behavior in our spaces. But anyway, we're back to the getting this chart settled and make sure that the legend stays active. So what you need to do is you need to, if you highlight one bar, that will highlight all of them, the whole series. And if I select no fill, then you can see that the lollipops appear, the bars disappear, but also that color disappears here. So I'm going to undo this. What you need to do is isolate each individual bar on its own. So click again, and then that bar will stay isolated, and then you can individually color code that one bar. When I select no fill, now you can see this blue square next to initiation stays. Now when I asked John if I could post my own chart and how he was doing it over on his blog, he also gave me a couple cool keyboard shortcuts that you might find useful if you're doing something like this. So when I push Control and the Control key and the right arrow key, it will automatically tab over to the next bar. And so you can see it, that next bar is highlighted, but the other bars aren't. And then if I push the F4 key, it will automatically color the bar in the same way that I colored the previous bar. So in this case, it will automatically make it no fill. So I don't have to go back and forth with my mouse and keep on clicking that if I don't want to. So let's push F4 and see what happens. I really hope it works. Yep, it didn't work. Maybe it's because this element is selected over here. Let's get out of this. I'm going to go ahead and isolate this first bar, click on no fill, perfect, control right arrow, F4. Nope, doesn't work. Let's try it again. Sometimes these things don't work, and sometimes it has to do with the way your keyboard is set up too. I'm going to say no fill there, control right arrow, F4. Now that worked, control right arrow, F4. Perfect. If I do the control arrow again, it's going to give me the next series highlighted completely. But then if I click the control right arrow again, it isolates that first bar. Let's see if pushing F4 will work. And it does. So you can see that you can really go through this quicker with those keyboard shortcuts. Let's do that. Highlights the orange series. And now we isolated that one bar. We'll see if this one works. That worked. F4. F4. And one last one for F4. Now, once we do that, you can see all of my lollipops show up, and my beautiful legend right here maintains its colors and is active throughout and will continue to be active in the chart if I change it. So that's a pretty cool trick. The other thing that I might want to do in this case, since we are using these lollipops, maybe I want the color next to the words, the legend words, to be circles. I don't think there's any way to do that in Excel unless you are doing some coding behind the scenes with VBA or something like that. But what I would just do is sort of brute force, insert tab, and then insert a circle. We're going to go ahead and just resize the circle. You hold the shift key and then you drag it down, and that maintains a proportional shape when you are stretching or making a shape smaller. Let's go ahead and just nudge that just a little bit so it's perfect. I'm going to push Control D to copy or duplicate it, really. And then let's make that the right color, and then Control D again. And that will be orange. Those are a little bit big, so what I might do is just select Shift and highlight all of them. And then maybe I'll make them a little bit smaller all as a group. I think that works pretty nice. And then you just want to sort of nudge them around a little bit just to make sure that they're in the right space. I'm just going to do that. And to make sure that they're all aligned perfectly to the middle, I'm going to highlight them all, go up to the Align tab, and then select Middle. And then I'm going to right-click and group them. So now they're treated as one aligned shape, and I can just put that whole group of objects right in front of my legend. So it looks pretty nice, don't you think? That's a really nice way to do it. And so thank you so much, Jon. Of course, in this new way, if I were to sort of brute force, put those circles over, those circles are not going to update with the legend. So that's kind of just a nice little aesthetic stylization. But if I wanted to just remove them and keep the legend there, it'll be nice and squared and colored. So perfect, perfect live legend in your chart. Really useful, especially when you're making charts like lollipops that aren't really an Excel default, and you kind of have to work with all the behind the scenes magic to make that happen. So if you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up, and make sure to click that subscribe button if you want notifications every time I post a new video in data design, PowerPoint, or Excel. Just click the bell and you can set your notification settings to that. You'll get notified right in your YouTube app every time I post a new video when inspiration strikes. Thanks again for watching. I had a great time making it for you. I hope you have a great day, and I will see you next time.